All right. We got one from Mo Amir.
Okay. Mo Amir.
Mo Amir, H-Town, Houston comic.
All right. First time. What we got?
This is move to the wrong part of Houston.
Right.
See that could be a problem.
Yeah, definitely moving into Houston, you should definitely check out geographically, you know.
There's parts you don't want to move to.
Right.
Parts you don't want
to
move
to. That's everywhere you go to, you know?
Yeah, everywhere got parts you know you want to stay away from. Everywhere.
Yeah. So if you have the choice of knowing where you're going, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah, look into the surroundings. But all right, let's see what Big Mo's got to say about this wrong side of Houston. All
right, here we go.
It's just weird. I was actually born in Kuwait, right? I left Kuwait after the first Gulf War. I was 9 years old. I went to a nice private British English school in Kuwait. I wore a little vest and a bow tie to school. I was an adorable Arab kid with a hint of a British accent. I was like, hello, mom, yeah, going to school, hey, mommy, yeah, all right, yeah. Then I ended up in Houston, Texas, very proud. I'm a very proud Houstonian.
Okay. Kuwait to Houston.
Super proud Houstonian from A-Leaf.
A-Leaf, okay.
Hold on. When I got there, they put me in ESL Everybody class, which is English as a second language class, and I was the only guy that spoke English in this fucking class. And my family sends me to school with a vest and a bow tie, thinking that's how you go to school. No, that's how you get your ass whooped at school in America. I walk in, all the kids are looking at me like, hola. Amigo, tú eres el nuevo aquí? Sorry? What language are you speaking? All of a sudden, this other dude just comes up out of nowhere. He's like, you're weird, dude. Golly, man. Why do you talk like that, eh? And that was my teacher. You know, it's fucked up.
Ah, damn.
My family did no research. Not one person thought of like, hey, what neighborhood should we move into in Houston? Let's just fucking go to a bunch of gang violence. That'll make sense.
Yeah.
It was very tough. Like, I didn't know what to do with it because I was caught in the middle of this gang battle. It's a lot of Mexican gangs, a lot of black gangs, and they're fighting each other. And then Mexican gangs wanted to recruit me because they thought I was Mexican. And there was a lot of black gangs. They wanted to beat me up because they thought I was Mexican. It's like really tough high school years. I'm like walking to school and I see these Latino gangs hanging out, and obviously this guy has seen me before and he just had it. He just approaches me. He was like, "Say, vato, you walk by here every day. You don't say nothing, don't do nothing. What? You ashamed of your own peoples, bro? You ashamed your own people? This is your familia, bro. You're a Rasta, bro. You ashamed of your own people, bro? Andale, bro. You're going to get broke today, bro. What's your name, bro? Andale, what's your name?" I was like, "Oh, man, my name is Muhammad." He's like, "What?" "For real, bro? You look exactly like Hector. I swear to God, bro." He was like, Hector, come check it out, dude. Check it out, bro. We found your doppelganger, te lo juro, bro, te lo juro. And the fucked up part is Hector came out. I was like, holy shit, I do look like Hector. Started high-fiving and shit. I was like, oh, yeah, we all look alike. And I saw some guns sticking out. I was like, oh, shit, need to get the hell out of this situation. And I did, and I had a decent day. I really did. And then I'm going home, and I see the black gangs hanging out. And I was like, please. Please, not today. I'm not emotionally prepared to deal with this today. Please, just not today. And of course, they smelled that fear from a mile away. For real, and this guy comes up to me, he was like, "Say, Jose. You in the wrong motherfucking neighborhood, Jose. You done fucked up today, Jose. Where your crew at, Jose?" I'm looking around for Jose. I'm like, who the hell is Jose? I was like, come on, man, my name is Muhammad. He goes, ah, oh, man, salam alaikum, brother. Shit, my bad. You
know? Shit, nigga. Here, watch where you walk, nigga. Watch what street you walk down. Fuck walking.
Walk quickly.
Yeah. Okay. You say it's a leaf. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Right around the corner.
Yeah, man. Dude's funny, man.
Yeah.
Dude's funny.
Yeah. It's funny.
Spoke a lot. He had a lot of good accents, man.
Yeah. From Kuwait. Came and moved to Houston. Damn, who does that? Moves from Kuwait directly to Houston. But he must have had family here or something. Like, I think you would move to like a, I don't know, like New York or something.
Send him to school with a vest and a bow tie.
Yeah. ESL. Everybody spoke Spanish in there.
Yeah, that bow tie wouldn't have lasted long, man, at all.
Nah, you can't. That's a death sentence.
Walking there, you should have figured that out. Yeah.
Although now people got their own styles, I think you could probably get away with a bow tie.
Oh, now then, in high school. Yeah. Sure.
I've seen people wear weirder shit to high school nowadays than a bow tie.
Yeah, I've seen some stuff you would have got whooped up in. Yeah, for being in nowadays. And now, you know, things change. You know?
Yeah, it's changed a lot. Changed a lot. Just back in the day.